finished synthesizing the samples. Ingest this pill, then go and find the source of the mold. Only there can we begin to understand how to stop it.
So you promise I won't end up walking around covered in mold?
Oh, the pill will prevent any biological infection by the mold.
Take a mystery pill because a rude lady in a hazmat suit tells you to. Great idea, Jesse.
Ugh. Honestly, did you want me to wrap it in cheese?
Not the taste, the smell. It stinks in here now.
Good. That means the pill is working. The worse it smells, the safer you'll be. Now go. Find the source.
Have you worked with Emily Pope?
Our paths have crossed. Darling arranged for us to have a coffee. A meeting of the minds, he called it. She's talented. I can certainly see her doing well here.
I feel like there's a but coming.
But she's drunk a bit too much of the Bureau's proverbial Kool-Aid. She shouldn't be afraid to forge ahead on her own. Science is skepticism. Everything must be questioned before the truth can emerge.
So, is Darling your boss?
If you insist on clinging to such outdated hierarchies, then... yes. However, I would argue that our fields are too dissimilar for one to manage the other. Of course, Darling would much prefer to find his own miracle solution to the Bureau's fungal frustrations. He always needs to be the hero.
So tell me again how you came to work at the Bureau.
Well, like I said, I was brought in as a special advisor. A temporary position, you see. Although that's not the whole truth. I was employed here for a time, straight out of university. After a decade of admittedly fascinating work in threshold research and regulation, I began to chafe under the bureaucracy. I needed a change. Not that academia was so different.
And then the mold happened.
About 4 months ago, yes. Since my departure from the Bureau, they hadn't been able to find my equal in threshold analysis. Darling and I had kept in touch over the years, meeting at conferences and the like. He called me, and I booked a flight. I've never been able to say no to a man with a dangerous alien biosphere. I had to leave my post in the middle of term, but so be it.
So she's a professor. That explains a lot.
The mold seems to be having some weird effects on things.
Indeed. Even people are susceptible. The fungus grows rapidly within the chest cavity, killing the host. Luckily, one must ingest the stalks to become infected.
Don't eat the mold. Okay.
We've always cremated the infected bodies after autopsy, but I believe there may be another stage of maturity. A blooming, if you will.
I never thought the word blooming would sound so horrible.
Thanks for the information.
My pleasure. I'll get back to the room.
This must be the pit Underhill was talking about.
Captain Lopez, reporting on Expedition 17B. Take the formation now. Visually, no distinction from the previous visit. The link detectors are still standing. One arch has a light flashing, so we're gonna give the area once over. Then we'll head back. Lopez out.
Go, the worse it smells.
They're all dead. These things killed them all.
Dave, you're inside by the door.
There are so many.
You want to drink?
You're listening. Get out. No!
Is that the source? It's kind of pretty.
No. Ramsey, Ranger Captain, Node 7.25. Underhill sent us down this weird-ass threshold looking for whatever's making all these vegetables sprout. I will say this, it smells delicious.
Returned, I see. And you're not sprouting mold from your eyes. I take it that means my pill worked. Now tell me everything. Did you find the source? You did, didn't you?
I found a big angry plant. Like, gigantic. I killed it.
You killed it? You found the source and you killed it? I could have learned so much from a live specimen.
Her concern is touching. Really, it's too much.
Here, I brought you a sample.
A piece of the innermost mold! You're not such a lost cause after all. Strange. So different, even superficially. Another stage of growth, perhaps.
Please, no more stages.
You'll be pleased to know that cutting down the creature at the source has already resulted in a notable cessation of the mold's rapid growth. You've bought me time for further study.
So what now?
I'm glad you asked. While you were busy in the pit, a number of mold hosts were sighted beyond the threshold. They managed to sneak out without the Rangers noticing. There's a reason I didn't send Steve and Andy to find the mold source with the others. These vagrant hosts must be eradicated as soon as possible. The mold can still be spread by their overgrown bodies.
Any idea where they went?
The hosts I've observed are not a sprightly bunch. Here are the reports I've received. They'll help you find them.
I'll go take care of them.
Good. And do be quick about it.
There's a nice way to say that.
Thanks for the information.
My pleasure.
should let Underhill know.
Look for laboratory door.
I found the hosts. They won't be spreading any more mold.
Well done. I'll send burn teams to sanitize the locations. I'm beginning to wonder if these hosts are originating outside the threshold in independent patches of mold growth.
You don't sound very optimistic.
Optimism is for farmers, as my mother always said. I suppose you could now return to that hiss business you all seem so concerned about.
This woman has some incredible tunnel vision.
Thanks for the information.
My pleasure.
They're endangering us by bringing a hiss in. If Trench was still around, he'd have stopped us.
Please. Trench was part of the same shadow. Every disaster this country has.
Thank you. About this Arish guy?
I heard some rangers saying he saved them in maintenance. They were attacked by a new kind of hiss, and Arish got them out.
All right, but still, a security guard leading rangers? I don't know if I like taking orders from a mall cop. They marched through here. Why the fuck did you put a bullet in that thing's head?
Did you hear that the hiss prisoner they captured is the director's brother?
Then she brought him here. She's gonna get us all killed.
This is Lynn Salvador, head of Bureau Security. I'm making a formal security order due to the incident in April, case number 21HQ593. Improper use of the jukebox altered item led to two fatalities. We believe a pair of agents used the jukebox to travel to the quarry threshold and engage in inappropriate workplace behavior. An expedition team found them decomposing at the formation's base a week later. At least we found out the jukebox doesn't bring corpses back when the song ends. I'm having the jukebox placed in a secure location in the executive sector. It should never have been accessible to low clearance staff in the first place. The new location security and proximity to a high traffic area will prevent misuse while still allowing for expedition teams to access it when required. See me for any further details. Thank you.
place while you're gone.
Lots of interesting data off that subject of the ranger.
I am waiting. Nothing to worry about.
Thank you.
can I be sure?